I want to thank STFX for coming out tonight for the presentation. Tonight's subject lecture is, of course, the sexy girl parties that go on our campus. And what they do for our youth is they provide sexual confidence. They are the most exciting sex that you can have without getting naked. Unfortunately, though, the sexy girl presentations are for women only. And that is the subject of tonight's lecture. Yeah! I don't know about you guys, but I think I speak for all men when I say I find sexy girl parties to be the single most fascinating thing on the face. It might be a male superiority thing when I say when a group of young women get together and men don't know what they're doing, it drives us crazy. It really does. Men are consumed with knowing what the women in their lives are doing at every single moment. For example, the female locker room, the slumber party, the bathroom, the powder room, these are all instances where men are forbidden to enter. And we don't know what they're doing, and this drives us crazy. Men will go through extraordinary lengths, as I will comment on, to know what exactly they were doing. But by far the holy grail, what takes the cake of all female mysteries, is the sexy girl party. Because of course you get women together and they draw the drapes shut and they tape over the windows and they involve themselves in cult-like activities. For example, I've been told, I've never been, how many girls here have been to a sexy girl party? Hands up. That's right. There's a lot of girls. Curry, put your hand down. He's never been. Guys aren't allowed. But what I've been told is that the purchases go on behind curtains or in secret rooms, and these women leave the rooms with products in unmarked paper bags. All very mysterious. It's a cult almost. It's like, in my mind, the Da Vinci Code meets exciting video. That's how a lot of guys see these kind of events. Earlier this year, I was caught sneaking into one of these events. Unfortunate, very awkward, and a female RA stops me and she says, Dan, what's your problem? Grow the fuck up, okay? No, these are girls getting together and they're expressing their sexuality. And she looks at me with almost disgust. And I look back at her with equal disgust and I say, did you miss sex ed in junior high? What's wrong with me? Behind that very door are 30 college girls in their pajamas with a whole whack of dildos, massage oil, and handcuffs. And you're asking me what is wrong with me? I would give my left leg to get in that room. But guys, they don't know what the fascination is, guys. I actually, on me, happen to have an invitation to a sexy girl website. This is actually available on sexygirlsonline.ca. I was disappointed when I went to the website, needless to say. And it says, you're invited to a sexy girl party. And when I printed this invitation off for myself, I was actually kind of excited. And if I were to make a note to myself, as pathetic as that seems, it says, dear Dan, you're invited to a party. Right away, I'm hooked. I don't get to that many parties. It says, come to a fun-filled gathering of naughty fun and games where you can see, sample, and taste a variety of sensuous products in the comfort of your own home. I'm sold. Hook, line, and sinker. Right there, I will go to whatever they are selling because it sounds that good. But ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you, it is not that easy. The lengths that guys will go to get in one of these parties borderlines pathetic. It is actually creepy. Y'all know what I'm talking about. The sexy girl party, it comes to your residence, and girls, you see the guys hours before the events lining the hallways. They're hanging out in the stairways, they're held together, they're hoping to get a glimpse of these mysterious women entering the room with these boxes of magical products. And it's really quite pathetic. Guys, you ever try this one? You know a sexy girl party is going to happen, and hours before, you scope out the lounge and you put your books in there. You put your scribblers, you put your textbooks, your pens and pencils, and you're thinking, if I look like my nose is in this book, the RAs won't kick me out. They can't, I'm studying. I'll get a few glimpses, I'll get a show, they'll continue what they're doing. It's completely fine. Wrong. Not gonna work. The RAs are scrupulous in kicking people out. The res office could learn a thing or two about sexy girl parties. Hell, the Patriots defense could learn a thing or two about sexy girl parties. Now I put this in perspective. On any given weekend, I can go to McIsaac Hall and I can piss in the elevator. Okay? And no, it gets worse. I can rip a sink off the wall in the male bathroom. And to cap it all off, I can pull the fire alarm, and it's no big deal. It happens every weekend. That's fine, but you want to get into a fucking traveling dildo sales workshop? No way. Not a chance. If you're a guy, it's not gonna happen. And this is just hours before the show starts. Once the party begins, it's like there's blood in the water, and us guys, we're all sharks. We're circling around the room, you know? The leader of the male floor gets all the guys together. It's a bit of a huddle, you know? Everyone gets together. And we think, how are we gonna get in there? Some guys will try the diplomatic route. A few guys will try bargaining. Not to name names, but I was in Plessy last year, and a few guys took turns sitting on each other's shoulders outside the lounge in Plessy. And Curry and I, didn't mean to say that, Curry, we were getting together at home just to get a glimpse. But you know what? It doesn't happen because the security is absolutely unreal at these events. So got us thinking, a few of my buddies and I, we were sitting in Lane, the Boneyard, we were having a few drinks in our room as it happens. And one of my friends, this was Curry again actually, he mentioned, I've got needs. I've got desires, I've got wants that aren't filled by the women in my lives. Why can't I have the equivalent to a sexy girl party? And this got me thinking, I said to myself, well, Curry, let me put it in perspective for you. I'm playing pickup hockey at the Millennium Center, okay? It's about, I don't know, 10 o'clock Friday night, and the game's over, we're taking our gear off in the lounge, and it goes around the room, what are you guys doing tonight? A few guys say, okay, well, you know, I'm doing work, I'm going to the library, I've got midterms or a paper, and that's fine. A few guys are going out, you know, they're going to Pat's or the pub, they're already getting into the beer, that's great. And the question would come to me, and they'd say, Coles, what are you doing tonight? And I'd say, well, guys, I'm going to a sexy boy party. I thought a few of the guys on my floor, we'd get together, we'd buy dildos and porn together, and that'd be the way I'd spend my Friday night. Unfortunately, ladies, if I said that to a group of hockey players, I guarantee you I would never, ever be invited back to that pickup hockey game ever. In fact, I can't think of any red-blooded male in the room who would go to a party entitled a sexy boy party. Unless you're a complete pervert or a pedophile, it's just not gonna happen. Girls, as much as it may pain you to imagine, think about what would go on if a sexy boy party were to happen. I mean, you know the men in your life. We're into what's bigger, what's better. We're into shock value. You know where I'm going with this. Let's assume the girlfriend, her roommate, is gone away for the weekend. Okay, we want to experiment. Maybe we pick up a dildo. Okay? You know, it's possible. People aren't into that. I was on the sexygirl.ca online website, and I looked at what passes for muster as a female dildo. And that's fine. They're very cute. The little minnow, the eager beaver, the dancing dolphin. I mean, they sound like things that you would touch at a petting zoo, which is cool. If you're a guy, that's not the case. I mean, you want more power. You're thinking Tim Allen here. You're thinking, you know? If I'm a guy and I'm gonna buy a dildo, it's gonna start with a fucking ripcord. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? I want diesel fuel. I want fumes. I want the RA on the floor to bang on the door and make sure we're okay. So the dancing dolphin is not gonna do. So I searched further. The internet, it's a magical place. I found out what would go for a male dildo. We're talking about, picture this, the Cosmic Invader Jelly Probe. Now that is an example of a dildo that a guy would buy. To me that sounds cool. Holy shit, a Cosmic Invader? Or how about this? The Anal Bandit 300. Anal twizzle stick. I'm not making this up, these are real things that are sold online. Girls, if a sexy boy party were ever to happen and it was to make money, the stuff they would have to sell would actually make you sick. And not only girls here, the weak and hurt males would actually be throwing up in the hallways if they were to know what would be sold. If a male sexy boy party were to exist, as weird as it sounds to say that, the stuff they would have to sell would be barely legal, imported off the Southeast Asians of Borneo, never to touch North American soil before sexual paraphernalia. Alright? I mean, the average guy weekend consists of a sexy girl party. I mean, we got porn off the internet, we got girls, we got porn makes, we got everything. So to actually make business, it would actually have to be ridiculous stuff. So leave it to me to research what ridiculous stuff is. There is such a thing as silicone erection molding kits, and they exist, and they're actually very popular. If a sexy boy party were to come to St. Evex, half the guys in lane would have a silicone replica of their penis sitting in their room. And it gets worse. You're familiar with Chia Pets, I'm sure. You know where I'm going with this. There is the Chia Muff. There is the perfect pussy and the full silicone replica rear entry porn star model. This is just a handful of things that would have to be sold at a male sexy party. I mean, a girl sexy party, they sell Wildwood brown sugar body polish. Right? This was sold at a girl sexy party. Karma Sutra honey dust. Girls buy this shit, guys. And I'm thinking to myself, if I'm with a bunch of guys in lane, if I'm with a bunch of guys in Plessy or Burke, whatever, I'm not going to raise my hand and say, ooh, I'll take two of the Karma Sutra honey dust. It's just not going to happen. But girls, it gets worse. Think about the guy who would run a sexy boy party. Now, I've been to the website. I know what a sexy girl dildo saleswoman looks like. She's young, she's beautiful, she's independent, she's intelligent, and she's sexually liberated. And these are all attractive qualities to me. But imagine the guy counterpart. Not so attractive. For starters, he's 40-something. Okay? He's got this greasy, long, black ponytail, a mustache, and a soul patch, which is gross as is, but it gets worse. He's got tight leather pants, a faux silk shirt with that porno-style tough hair coming out. Worse, he makes porn stars look classy. This guy is the definition of skis. Half the girls on campus probably have restraining orders against him. And he's probably got most of the STIs known to man. So what it comes down to, ladies, is that if guys were to ever have a sexy boy party, as much as we begged and we pleaded for girls to come to one of our events, girls simply want to come, and that wouldn't want to come, and that's the irony. Is that, in fact, I don't know if most of the guys I know would want to come to a sexy boy party. Anyway, Anna Ganesh, you guys have been great. Thank you very much.